Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the session on Standard on Review Engagement 2410 on review of interim financial information performed by the independent auditor of the entity. Myself, CA Amit Goel. This is a very important standard. This is of a great significance in the current scenario as all the listed companies are required to get their interim financial information reviewed by the independent auditors. And even in case of other companies, whenever they want their interim financial information to be reviewed by the independent auditors, these standards gives the guiding principles. So we will start with the overview. This standard contains introduction, general principles of a review of a interim financial information, objectives of an engagement to review interim financial information, agreeing the terms of the engagement, procedures for a review of interim financial information, evaluation of misstatements, management representations, auditor's responsibility for accompanying information, communication, reporting the nature, extent and results of review of interim financial information, documentation, effective date, appendices. Appendices contain the sample format for draft engagement letter, draft review reports, draft management representation letters. So we will start with the introduction. What is an interim financial information? Interim financial information is prepared and presented in accordance with applicable financial reporting framework. It comprises either a complete set or a condensed set of financial statement. It is for a period that is shorter than the entity's financial year. So even a complete set of financial statement which is prepared for a period shorter than the entity's financial year will be termed as interim financial information. So the triggering point is the duration for which financial statement is prepared to be classified as financial information or interim financial information. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has issued two standards on review engagement. One, SRE 2400, which is on review of interim financial information by a practitioner. Another one, 2410, on review of interim financial information by the independent auditor of the entity. As an independent auditor, during the audit engagement, the independent auditor would have obtained understanding of the entity and its environment, including internal controls. The auditor updates his knowledge of the client's business and control environment while conducting the review and accordingly plan the inquiry and the analytical procedures, whereas the other practitioner is not accustomed and does not have the knowledge of the client business to that extent. Therefore, this standard is directed towards review of interim financial information by an entity's auditor. Now we move to general principles of review of interim financial information. Interim financial information must comply with the ethical requirement applicable to the audit of annual financial statement of the entity, such as independence, integrity, objectivity, professional competence and due care, confidentiality, professional behavior, and technical standards. The independent auditor must implement quality control procedures applicable to the individual engagement, like leadership responsibility for quality of an engagement, ethical requirement, acceptance and continuation of client relationships and specific engagement, assignment of engagement teams, engagement performance and monitoring. The independent auditor must plan and perform the engagement with the attitude of professional skepticism, so as to recognize existence of circumstances that require a material adjustment in interim financial information so as to enable it to be prepared in all material respects in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework. Now we move to the objectives of engagement to review interim financial information. Review of interim financial information enables auditor to express a conclusion whether, on the basis of the review, anything has come to the auditor's attention that causes auditor to believe that interim financial information is not prepared in all material respects in accordance with applicable financial reporting framework. Review of interim financial information does not provide a basis for expressing an opinion whether the financial information gives a true and fair view or is presently fairly in all material respects in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework. The review is also not designed to obtain a reasonable assurance that interim financial information is free from material misstatement. Now we move to the agreeing the terms of the engagement. The auditor must agree with the client on the terms of engagement before the start of the review. Terms of engagement are ordinarily recorded in the engagement letter. Engagement letter avoids misunderstanding with respect to nature of engagement, objective and scope of review, management responsibilities, auditor responsibilities, assurance to be obtained, nature and form of report. Now we move to procedures for a review of interim financial information. The auditor must obtain understanding of the entity and its environment, including its internal controls. It is needed because it relates to preparation of annual financial information as well as interim financial information. The knowledge should be sufficient to plan and conduct review to identify types of potential material misstatements and consider likelihood of their occurrence and select inquiries and analyticals and other review procedures. The auditor must update understanding obtained during annual audits with respect to preparation of annual financial statement. The auditor must obtain sufficient understanding of internal control over preparation of interim financial information. Obtaining sufficient understanding of internal control or interim financial information is necessary because the internal controls may be different for interim financial information as compared to the annual financial information. Once auditor obtained the knowledge about the entity and its environment, then the auditor is required to use the understanding to determine inquiries to be made and analytical and other review procedures to be applied. The auditor will identify particular events, transactions, assertions to which inquiries and other procedures may be directed or applied. The auditor must determine the nature of review procedures required for component. The factors to be considered are component's materiality, risk of misstatement in component's interim financial information, extent of centralization or decentralization of internal controls over preparation of the component's interim financial information. To gain knowledge about the entity and its control environment, the auditor can refer to reading documentation of the preceding year's audit and review of prior interim period of the current year and corresponding interim period of the prior year to enable the auditor to identify matters that may affect the current period. The auditor may get the knowledge by reading the most recent annual and comparable prior period interim financial information. The auditor may consider significant financial accounting and reporting matter that may be of continuing significance, such as material weaknesses in internal control. The auditor may gain knowledge by considering results of any internal audit performed and the subsequent action taken by the management. The auditor may inquire the management about the effect of change in entities' business activity. The auditor may gain knowledge by inquiring the management about any significant changes in internal control and the potential effect of any such change on the preparation of interim financial information. Once the auditor obtains knowledge about the entity and its control environment, then the auditor is required to make inquiries and perform analytical and other review procedures to conduct the review. The auditor must make inquiries and perform analytical and other review procedures. The nature and the extent of inquiry and analytical and other review procedures are affected by understanding of entity and its environment, result of risk assessment relating to preceding audit, materiality considerations. Ordinarily, for conducting review, the auditor is not required to test accounting records through inspection, observation, and confirmation. Some procedures can be applied before or simultaneously with the preparation of internal interim financial information. The auditor is not required to obtain direct external confirmation ordinarily while conducting the review. The auditor must obtain evidence that interim financial information agrees or reconciles with the underlying accounting records. The auditor must inquire the management if all the events up to the date of review report that may require adjustment or disclosure in the interim financial information have been identified, or any changes in going concern assessment made by the management. The auditor generally make inquiries primarily of the persons responsible for financial and accounting matters and perform analytical on the basis of the conclusion made by the inquiry of those persons. Now we move to evaluation of misstatement. The auditor must evaluate individually and in aggregate whether uncorrected misstatements that has come to auditor's attention are material to interim financial information. The auditor is not required to obtain reasonable assurance that interim financial information is free of material misstatement. The auditor must exercise professional judgment in evaluating materiality of the misstatements. The auditor may designate amount below which aggregation not to be done if such aggregation would not have material impact on the interim financial information. Now we move to management representations. The auditor must obtain representation from the management regarding the responsibility of the management for design and implementation of internal control to prevent and detect fraud and error. The auditor must obtain representation that interim financial information is prepared and presented in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework. The auditor must obtain a representation that uncorrected misstatement aggregated by auditor during review are immaterial both individually and in aggregate to the interim financial information. The auditor must take representation that the management has disclosed to the auditor all significant facts relating to any frauds or suspected frauds known to management that may have affected the entity, results of its assessment of the risk that the interim financial information may be materially misstated as a result of fraud, that all known actual or possible non-compliance with laws and regulations whose effects are to be considered when preparing the interim financial information, that all significant events that have occurred subsequent to the balance sheet date and through to the date of the review report that may require adjustment to or disclosure in interim financial information. The auditor must also obtain additional representation as are appropriate related to the matters specific to the entity's business or industry in which the entity. Now we move to auditor's responsibility for accompanying information. The auditor must read other accompanying information to consider whether any such information is materially inconsistent with the interim financial information. If auditor considers that other information contains a material misstatement of the fact, then he must discuss the matter with the management. If an amendment is necessary to correct the material misstatement of the facts and management refuses to make the amendment, the auditor considers taking further action as appropriate, such as notifying the same to those charged with the governance and obtaining legal advice. Now we move to the communication with those charged with the governance. If during the review auditor believes that it is necessary to make a material adjustment to interim financial information, he must communicate this matter as soon as practicable to appropriate level of management. If management does not respond appropriately within a reasonable time, then he must inform the same to those charged with the governance. If those charged with the governance do not respond appropriately within the reasonable time, then he must consider whether to modify the report or possibility of withdrawing from the engagement and even the possibility of resigning from appointment to audit the annual financial statement. Now we move to communication of non-compliances. If a matter comes to auditor's attention that causes auditor to believe in existence of a fraud or non-compliance by the entity with respect to law and regulations, then he must communicate the matter as soon as practicable to the appropriate level of management. He must communicate the relevant matter of a governance interest arising from review of interim financial information to those charged with the governance. Now we come to the review report. The review report must contain the title that it is a review report. It must contain the addressee to whom it has to be addressed as per terms of engagement. It must contain that it is a report on the interim financial information. It must contain a para regarding the responsibility of the management regarding preparation of interim financial information and related internal control. It must contain a para relating to the auditor's responsibility. It must contain a statement that review has been conducted in compliance with this standard. It must contain a statement that the scope of the review is less than audit. It must contain the conclusion of the auditor. It must contain the date of the report. It must contain the place of the signature. It must contain the name and the membership number of the person who is signing the report. It must contain the firm registration number. And now with effect from 1st July 2019, it must contain unique document identification number as well. In some of the law and regulation may prescribe wording for the auditor's report on conclusion that is different from the wording which is mentioned in this standard. Although auditor may be obliged to use those prescribed wording, but the responsibility of the auditor as described in this standard for coming to the conclusion will remain the same. Now we move to the departure from the applicable financial reporting framework. When a matter has come to the auditor's attention that causes auditor to believe that a material adjustment should be made to the interim financial information for it to be prepared in all material respect in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework, then the auditor must consider to express a qualified or adverse conclusion in his review report. Now we move to the limitation on the scope of review. If an auditor is unable to complete review, then he must communicate in writing to the appropriate level of management and to those who are charged with the governance the reason why review cannot be completed, and he must consider whether it is appropriate to issue a report. It may happen that with the preliminary knowledge of the entity, the auditor may be aware of the fact that he will not be able to complete the review even before accepting the engagement. In that scenario, he should not accept the engagement. If after the acceptance of the engagement, limitation is imposed by the management, then the auditor must request the management for removal of the limitation on the scope. If management refuses, then he must communicate in writing to the management and those charged with the governance regarding why engagement cannot be completed, and he must consider legal and regulatory responsibilities. Now we move to going concern and significant uncertainties. The auditor must assess the going concern assumptions while conducting the review. If a material uncertainty regarding entity's ability to continue as a going concern exists, then auditor must ensure whether adequate disclosure is made in the interim financial information. If yes, then auditor must add a para of emphasis of matter in his review report. However, if adequate disclosure is not made in the interim financial information, then auditor must consider to express a qualified or adverse conclusion as considered appropriate. The auditor must also include a specific reference to fact of such material uncertainty. Now we move to the documentation. The documentation is that is sufficient and appropriate to provide a basis for the auditor's conclusion and provide evidence that review was performed in accordance with the provision of this standard and applicable legal and regulatory requirements. This standard is effective from 1st April 2010. Thank you.